Earlier this week, the Biden administration unfortunately came out and said, hey, Iran is getting closer and closer to being, you know, a nuclear power on the global stage, and we can't have that. In response to that, Iranian officials came out and said, hey, listen, since you're talking about us and our nuclear capabilities, y'all want to get back into this agreement that we had. Like, we welcome you back. We're willing to come back. Let's sit down. Let's talk about this. Let's get an agreement working again so that both sides can benefit. And the Biden administration said no. In the weeks before the transition actually took place, when Donald Trump seemed very likely to be attacking Iran, you know, they were sending our planes to fly right along the border, just goading them into attacking us. They had their warships stationed out there ready to get troops into Iran. But Iran didn't take the bait. Thank God. And I kept saying then, when Biden comes into office, one of the first things he has to do is iron out this situation and, most importantly, get us back into the Iran agreement. And here the opportunity arises, but instead of doing the right thing, they're doing the Trump thing. They're doing the warmonger thing. They're out there telling us that, oh, Iran is this big threat, they're a huge threat, oh my God, they could have nukes. And then Iran says, well, hey, do you want us to get rid of them? Because, like, we're willing to do that, and we'll even talk to you about it. You can be a part of it. So what do you want to do? And then they say, no, go away. Go away. You're ruining our talking points, basically. That's what's happening right now. They're ruining our talking points. The Iranian officials are kind of dumbfounded at the moment. Like, they can't believe the guy who was a part of the original administration who came up with this deal is now saying no. I can't believe that this is happening to a degree. I mean, especially, yeah, considering that this was an Obama thing, so why wouldn't Biden want to jump back in it? He loves Obama. He loves continuing Obama stuff. This was one of the good things that came out of the Obama administration. But the war powers are louder. The war powers mean more to those in charge. And we know that some of Biden's picks in foreign policy are hawks. This is the wrong path. This is the wrong decision. And hopefully they revisit this and they overturn it. And the other thing, by the way, is that some reports contradict the Biden administration's claims of Iran being closer to nuclear capabilities. Do you know why? Because Iran is actually still in that agreement with other countries. And other countries have been monitoring them. Other countries have been inspecting. And they haven't sounded any alarm bells. The only people sounding any alarm bells are the United States. Gee, I wonder why that is.